Okay, welcome back. Last time we challenged Morty at the Acrotique City Gym, and then made our way down to Olivine City after winning our fourth badge. In addition to that, our Drowsy evolved into Hypno, and in this episode, we're pretty much just gonna do all the stuff in Olivine City. And by that, I mean, I'm going to hopefully get through the lighthouse faster than I think I'm going to. And, where is the lucky egg? There we go. Pretty much my new plan for this is, since the next gym I have to handle is a fighting type gym, I'm just gonna level up Magnemite in this episode, so it'll be level 30 and evolve into Magneton, assumably before the next gym battle. And also, before I go in, I wanna quickly check on a couple of things, because I hadn't checked on what this bonus mat was. Okay, apparently we can just buy Moo Moo Milk, which is even more practical from there. And Cassib Berries, I don't think do anything for us. Okay, we got a Super Potion, so that's nice. And that was all. Okay. Also, at the end of the previous episode, I came over to about here and tried to surf and I couldn't. For some reason, if you try to surf here, it works. One step further south and it considers you as being like in the port or something. So you can't. And it's just a bit inconvenient, really. Okay, but now we have a Tentacool that we can catch as our encounter for Olivine City. And yeah. So I'm just gonna quickly throw a netball at this and assumably it'll just stay in. It's a level 13 Tentacool, we should be okay. So, we have now successfully caught that Tentacool, always good to have. And now, I don't have a name plan for it, so it's going directly into the box of I'll think of names for it later Pokemon. And of course, the very next thing we run into is the same thing, but 8 levels higher. And I know that it's also possible that I could have found Tentacruel here, which honestly would have been even better. Because, well, it's an evolved Pokemon. Okay, what's this? TM91 Wing Attack. Okay, so TM91 is normally Flash Cannon. So anything that I could normally teach Flash Cannon, I can teach Wing Attack. I don't think I'm going to need to teach Magnemite / Magneton / eventually Magnezone Wing Attack. You know, because it's a special attacker. Actually, that's a nice idea. I could go back to the Elex Forest at some point and teach Hypno Eruption. Because the move tutor for Headbutt had been randomized to teaching Eruption. But at the same time, Eruption works on the amount of health you have. It's basically just a fire type version of Water Spout. So I imagine it wouldn't really be all that helpful. Well, because, you know, Hypno is not a fast Pokemon, it would basically be taking a hit every time it would be using Eruption anyway. I mean, I say that, but then again, it's also entirely feasible that I could give it the Quick Claw to try to, like, alleviate that. And I'm just gonna quickly run and drop the Tentacool off into the PC. And, honestly, we won't need it. So pretty much, the aim for today's episode is nothing. No, I don't want to draw. I do not want to remove Quagsire from the party. Pretty much, the aim for today's episode is just scale the lighthouse and then surf down to Cianwood City. And then after that, between this episode and the next one, I'll probably do some grinding to just try and get my to get my party to be at an acceptable level where I think I would have. To get to a level where I feel like I would have a chance of winning here, inning against Chuck. I know he only has 2 Pokemon, but they're both evolved. He has a Poliwrath and a Primeape. And even though I do have a Noctowl and a Hypno, I do still have 2 giant super effective weaknesses to fighting. And both of those Pokemon hit pretty darn hard. So I would, you know, just like to have a bit of insurance before I actually go into that fight. Okay, so this guy has a Noctowl, which, since he only has 1 Pokemon, I think, that's what. I'm pretty sure he only has the 1 Pokemon, which is why it's way higher level than most of the other Pokemon I'll end up fighting in here. Like, at this point in the game, I would expect every trainer to have, like, level 24s. Plus and stuff. But, like, because it's Johto, in here, most of the people that we'll be fighting probably won't even be hitting level 20. But that's unfortunately just a... Can I please stop hitting myself in confusion? Can I please just break out of confusion? Oh no, oh no, 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 no. Okay, that's a... that's a danger zone. So, let's swap to Hypno. I nearly just lost my Magnemite to a Noctowl. After this playthrough, I don't think I can ever talk smack about Noctowl ever again. Not that I would in most scenarios, because Noctowl's actually pretty cool and very cool. I hazard to use the word good, because in most cases it really just kind of isn't. And honestly, okay, the Reflect explains a lot. I forgot to put Reflect up. Because that headbutt did no damage at all. Also, turn, we managed to beat one guy, and I'm immediately going back to the Pokemon Center. Hopefully we won't have to leave again. Actually, well, I can quickly just flip the running shoes to be just on permanently now again. Because I don't need to worry about any, like, precise walking. And I also won't need to worry about that ever again in the game, actually, I don't think. Because I don't think there's another place that really requires it. Maybe the Bell Tower when we eventually do a Legendaries episode, like, right at the end. Actually, this is actually the first time I'm going to be playing one where I have to interact with a Legendary, like, on the way to the end of the game. So maybe I'll catch whatever, like, because I'm playing Soulsilver, I think what I'll do is I'll catch whatever Lugia is randomized to in this bit, and then all the other ones I'll do in a separate episode. I'm mostly just hoping that when I do come to do all of my legendary encounters, that it's something good. But it's just like, if I can get a Groudon or a Kyogre, that'd be really nice. Lugia, if Lugia randomized back to itself, I wouldn't be annoyed, but it wouldn't be my first choice. Also, I feel like I should be a bit careful here, because I think Poliwhirl does get Mudshot. I don't know what level, and getting a crit in one shot definitely just removes that issue, but I'm pretty sure that it does actually get Mudshot. Or maybe it's Mud Bomb. Either way, we just, you know, collect another phone number for the list of people who will occasionally call and we will never talk to. Okay, this guy is a bird keeper who has, I think he has five. I'm pretty sure he has just five level 15 Pidgeys or something. I mean, they'll all be higher level, obviously, because of the boost. But either way, we have a level advantage and a super effective stab, so yeah, we're just gonna one-shot all of his. All of his Pidgeys are just gonna get one-shot here. I mean, I was wrong about them all being level 15, and obviously, I was obviously wrong about them all being level 15 prior to the boost, because as there was one level 19 and two level 17s so far. And honestly, either way, it doesn't make a difference. They could all be Pidgeotos, and I don't think it would make a difference. Like, it can be... Actually, no, if it was a Pidgey, two Pidgeotos, and two Pidgeots, it would probably actually make a difference. It's because I imagine Pidgeot might be able to, would probably be able to outspeed Magnemite. Okay, that one's level 21, so... I mean, that's exactly the same. It's still a Pidgey. I know that, like, it doesn't force the evolutions yet, but, like, he should have just had Pidgeotos. Or, like, even just one Noctowl with him or something, or a Hoothoot with him. Just not five of the exact same Pokemon. Also, I'm pretty sure that these two trainers in here, like, I, th- think these two trainers on this floor are the two gym trainers, as in the Olivine City gym itself. However, at the same time, there are no trainers that you actually fight in the Olivine City gym. Once you help Amphy, you get better. When you go in, they'll both stop you as if they would fight you, and then they just pretty much thank you for going and helping. Okay, lock on. We absolutely do not need lock on. Like, lock on is a move that is pretty much just there in Magneton's learn. Oh, that is really good. TM for nasty plot. What has that written over as a question? TM 53. It's a psychic move normally, so we probably can't learn it. Yeah, we can't teach it to anything. I'll be real, I don't really remember what the later TMs are. Like, I know the TM chart in Gen 3, and as a result, I also know, like, the first 50 in Gen 4, I think. But, like, if you ask me about the ones from Gen 4 onwards, I'm a bit iffy on them. Like, I remember some of the important ones. I'm, like, I think 89... I think it's like 91 is Flash Cannon, 90 is... I know that 90, 91, and 92 are Substitute, Flash Cannon, and Trick Room. 89 is U-Turn. 81 is... 81 is U-Turn. No, 81 is X-Scissor. Then it's like 71, and I think it's either 76 or 77. Stone Edge and Dark Pulse, but honestly, after that, I pretty much just don't remember them. I think 56 is Charge Beam. Or is it 54? I don't know. I'm not good with the late ATMs. If you give me a quiz on the ones in Gen 3, I could probably just do all of it immediately in one go. Oh, but for the later gens, I genuinely just don't. I just don't know. Okay, we found a Mago Berry. Okay. Also, I kind of like the... Because I'm playing this at, like, kind of sunset-ish time. I mean, I'm playing this at 5:30 p.m. on New Year's Eve. At the end of 2021. So, yeah, that's how far ahead I'm recording this. Because, to be totally honest, I know I've stated this a few times already, but just as a quick reminder, I finished recording Emerald and still just wanted to play more Pokemon. So I decided, well, I was probably going to do Heartgold, Soulsilver at some point. So I might as well just, like, record this now, when I still feel like playing Pokemon on again. And I don't know, I can just put it up at some point in the future. And basically, you know, something has gone horrendously wrong with my plan if this goes up directly after Emerald. Also, we just picked up a Baribi Berry. I think that's the reduces a super effective steel move of Berry. Unfortunately, that isn't really going to see any use, because currently no one on our team is weak to steel. And also, steel types are not particularly common. However, if I do somehow end up with an ice or rock type, on my team before I fight Jasmine, maybe I could end up using this. But honestly, I wouldn't count on it. Because also in this gen, fairy type does not exist yet. Fairy type, when this game came out, was 3 years away. Or 4 years in Japan, because I think this game came out in like... I think this game was late 2009 in Japan. I might be wrong on that. But like, I don't know. Like, I don't know the Japanese release dates for them. Like, I'm pretty sure that from X and Y onwards, they were all pretty much worldwide releases, I think. Which one was it? I think Oris came out in Europe like 2 weeks later or something. And because of a shenanigans thing that had occurred at when X and Y were coming out. Also, I'll probably mention it at some point. I'll probably go into more detail at some point in the future when I actually decide to do X and Y. But honestly, I really like Gen 6, and I wish it had been given the time it deserved. loved because it really feels like, because it genuinely feels like they just kind of got most of the way through it, had a whole plan for Zygarde, and just went, we'll do Sun and Moon, actually. Which is a shame, because I don't really like Sun and Moon very much. Like, I don't know, I haven't played through Sun and Moon in a good while. Like, the last time I played through them properly was, like, probably the middle of 2019, you know, something? So it's been a good while since I actually played Pokemon Sun and Moon. So maybe next time I go through them, I will have a more positive reception of them. But as it stands, they are far from my favorite Pokemon games. And Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon, I just completely skipped because I didn't really see much point in them. And then, realistically, what I should have done was skipped Sun and Moon and played Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon. But, I don't know, at some point in the future, I will probably do Sun and Moon as well. I mean, I also need to do Black Knight and Black Knight 2 as well. Because I also need to do Platinum, because at some point I want to do all of the Pokemon games. And, I might do a ROM hack or two every now and then. But I don't intend on doing exclusively Pokemon. But, like, I don't know, Pokemon's just simple and easy to play. Also, okay, we've made it to the top of the lighthouse. So, basically, Jasmine tells you about the pharmacy in Cianwood, that Ampharos is sick, and that as a result, she can't just go and do the thing, so can you go to Cianwood and get the medicine for Amphy? Also, I would just like to note, because we'll come back to a room that is almost exactly the same as this later in the game, and there's the trees and the path there, which I think is meant to basically be Route 35? I'm just going to point that out now, and I will make reference back to it, if I remember, when we deal with when we finish off dealing with Team Rocket in Goldenrod City at the Radio Tower, because I'm pretty sure they just use the same asset again, or at least almost the exact same asset for that, because they look... I know that's like a top of a tower, a kind of circular room, but like, they are incredibly alarmingly similar. And we also have another surfing section. Which one? Cool. I don't mind surfing sections, because also it means water types, so I can, you know, beat up water types. Again, I'm also just going to try to dodge some of the trainers, and I can just use those for grinding later. I say as I surf directly into one. Am I going to see inward? Yes. And also, I know that on Route 41, I think it's on Route 41, I'm now guaranteed, unless I wait for it and use a fishing rod. Like, unless I use a fishing rod, I'm now guaranteed a Mantine encounter, which is great because I absolutely adore Mantine. It's one of my favorite water types. Like, yes, its stats aren't amazing. It's a special wall until the end of time, until it gets hit by an electric type move. I don't even know what just happened to my voice there. It's a good special wall until it gets hit by an electric type move, which, you know, it's quad weak to. No, I just think it's a very cool and also kind of cute Pokemon. I just like Mantine, it's one of my favorite Johto Pokemon. Okay, swim up all with... I assume she's just going to have two Staryus. And that is good enough for me, because that means I will be able to get enough EXP to get Magnemite to evolve. And also, absolutely just destroyed. Absolutely just destroyed that. Okay, Magnet Bomb. It would be nice to have a Steel-type stab, but at the same time, it's a physical move. But also, it doesn't miss. But I'm still going to pass on it. I'll just teach it Flash Cannon at a later time. That might have been an error on my part now that I think about it, because I don't think it learns Flash Cannon by level up. And the TMs are randomized, so I might not actually even be able to get Flash Cannon. But on the plus side, our starter is finally evolving. So Valkyrian the Magnemite, right, is finally evolving and becoming... Well, it's returned to its power state that it was in Emerald. Well, it is now Valkyrian the Magneton, and it's offering me Magnet Bomb again. And I think I'm still gonna pass on it. Basically, my logic for thinking this is, yes, it may be inconvenient to be missing out on having a Steel-type stab, but at the same time, having Sonic Boom, just for now at least, would still be helpful just for catching Pokemon. And also, I just completely lost all of my trains of thought, and that is a very nice special attack stat. 85? Yeah, that is by far my strongest Pokemon now. Magneton is legitimately going to be hitting almost twice as hard as almost all of my other Pokemon. So, who do I swap in now? I guess I'll just put Noctowl back to the front of the party for now. Oh, and I should have just gone the other way through the bag. However, I do want to be a bit careful with my levels, because while I do have my level cap here, I also have to be careful because I have to deal with the entire Team Rocket hideout as well, in Mahogany Town, before I deal with anything else. Wait, okay, so that's Cianwood City there. So is it Route 41 as soon as I hit the water? Okay, it is. Cool. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna surf up and down the coast until I get a couple of encounters, and if Mantine doesn't appear, I'll just make a cut until it appears. Because I know that in the encounter table it's just Tentacool, Tentacruel, and Mantine in the water here. I'd been surfing around, looking for about 20 minutes, and then it clicked in my mind. Mantine is only in Heartgold, it's not in Soulsilver. So I wasted my time, and that was a giant waste of my time. Because, yeah, that was, that's probably the single worst thing. Yeah, that's the worst. So I just, spent 20 minutes surfing up and down the coast, looking for a Mantine that would never, ever appear. Yeah, that's a little bit. On the annoying side. On the plus side, we may not have gotten an encounter, but we can go in here and talk to this guy. Right, and pretty much, Silver scared him into. Yeah, Silver scared him, so he gives us a Pokemon. Normally, this is a Shuckle called Shucky. So what do we have? We have a Pinsir. Okay, we have Shucky the Pinsir. Honestly, this Pinsir could maybe see its way onto the team, because Pinsir is pretty good. But not right now. Okay, so what I need to do now is actually decide on something. Because my level cap is 31 right now, so I could do my grinding and challenge the gym right now, or I could go back to Ecruteak and over and along towards Mahogany Town, deal with the Team Rocket base there, and then just do like three gyms back to back to back, and that would probably be like one episode. Good. So I don't really know what I'm gonna do, but at the same time, I'd have to surf back, because you gain Fly and the ability to use Fly outside of battle. Yeah, it's basically you got Fly and the ability to use Fly outside of battle for beating the Cianwood City Gym. But before I forget to do it, I'm going to go and pick up this. That's because we do need the, whatchamacallit, we need the secret potion. Okay, so I'm gonna drop Shucky off, I'm gonna just drop the Pinsir that we got into the PC. And it's going to be a little bit on the inconvenient side, Right, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna end the episode off here, and in the next one, I'll start back in Ecruteague, and then we'll go over to Mahogany Town, do all the stuff with Lake of Rage, deal with the Team Rocket hideout, and from there, I'll just do all the gems back to back to back. Then we can handle the Team Rocket stuff at the Radio Tower. And I think that would be probably the most convenient way for me to do it within my potential level caps without really running the risk of going over. I'll start the next episode back in the Ecruteague City Pokemon Center, and we'll be doing stuff in Mahogany Town. So I will hopefully see you all for that next time. Okay, later.